So yeah, good morning all, and welcome to another lecture of microprocessor programming of 8085. And I expect that everything is fine at your end and you are keeping good. So we are starting with today's program of 8085. Today we have to do the program of to compare or to know how much times a number appears in an array. So we have a number of 256 bytes, means we are having 256 numbers, and in that we have to check how many times a particular number appears, right? That is actually in the list, the B16th program that we are having. So let us start with my presentation. I guess this is visible to you all. Let me check, this is first time I'm using this. Okay, animation is there, right? So yeah, let me introduce myself. I am Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Electronics, Sri Mathuradas Mohta College of Science, and I welcome you all in this lecture of 8085 programming. And we have studied many of the programs that I have already uploaded on my YouTube channel. And today, what we are going to do is, let us start with this. So this is what we are trying to do. Oh, I have not changed this. So in this lecture, I guess today we are going to do the program in which we need to check how many times a particular number, specified number, appears. So we are going to do that program. And in that we need to use these instructions. So the basic instruction that we are going to use in this is compare. So compare means data in register or a memory location can be compared with the contents of the accumulator to show whether that number is equal, whether that number is greater than, or whether that number is less than the contents of the accumulator, right? So all the flags are being affected, and depending on the change in the condition of the flag, we can use that condition and we can do the program. So today, what we need to compare is, we need to compare a number which should be equal to that specified number in the accumulator, right? And in that case, what we need to mean that it should be equal. So both the numbers should be equal, and by that, what happens, we'll come to know. So the second logical, that is the logical instruction that we are going to use here, is the compare, CMPR or CMPM. Now, by default, one of the contents is supposed to be in the accumulator, right? So the contents of the accumulator is compared with the register, the content of the register or the content of the memory. Perfect. So in this case, we need to compare the contents of the accumulator with the memory. And what happens in this instruction is, it virtually subtracts the content of the accumulator with the register, or the contents of the register with the accumulator, but both the contents remain as it is and no contents are being disturbed. So both the contents are preserved and the results are shown in the comparison flag, or shown by the setting flag of program status word. And it shows like as so if the content of the accumulator is less than the content of register or memory, the carry flag is set. This is what we have used earlier. If the content of the accumulator is equal to the content of the register or memory, then the zero flag is set. Set means the zero flag becomes one. Whether it is earlier it was zero or whether it was one, that is to be noted. But it becomes one, that is, it's set, right? And this is a condition that we need to use. And this is the last condition. If A is greater than, if the content of the accumulator is greater than the content of register or memory, then carry and zero flags are reset, right? Carry and zero flags are reset, means they become C. Right. So this instruction is compare B or compare M. This is how we are going to use this. And in this program, we need to use compare M. So let us start with the program. So yeah, this is a program that we need to start, that this is B16 in the list. So So some data is stored in memory location starting from 6200 to 6300. In this data, find out how many times a byte EB appears. Remember this, how many times a byte EB appears. So we need to check how many times EB is there in that particular program, right? So that is to be checked over there. So let us start with that. So this is the flow chart of the program. We have to start, we have to initialize the initial memory location where the data is being kept. So it is mentioned over here, it is starting from 6200. So initially we have to load with load the HL pair with 6200, and we have to put a counter over there which will count this 256 numbers starting from 6200 to 6300 up to. So we'll be putting that in say register B. You know, the flowchart it is written as register C, but we are putting it in register B. And also we need to have to show the count. We have to initialize some of the registers. So we might be using register D for that. And we are putting the number, that is EB, in this accumulator. And then we need to check for the same number as that of EB. So we'll check it out. And if it is yes, then we'll increase the counter. If it is no, then we will decrement the counter that is being used to decrement the number of the register C. Then we have to check whether that count has become zero or not. If it is not zero, then it should repeat the procedure for 256 times. And we need to store that result in some of the registers. So we might be using register D for that. And then we will be stopping the processing, right? So this is actually the flowchart of the program which we need to do. So I guess you have understood the program, but still let us start with that algorithm. So what it actually means is, what we have to do, we have to load the address of the first number in HL pair. Second, move the count to register B. Third, the first number in the memory location, make the contents of accumulator to EB. Then we have to again put one instruction over there, that is to store the count. So we might be using making zero to register D, and we'll be storing that count, that number of counts, that how many times EB is appearing in that register C. Then we'll be comparing the number with that of register A. And if it is equal, then we'll be incrementing the count. Otherwise, we'll go on checking the other numbers. And we'll be storing that number, the number of counts in the some of the registers. And at the end, we are going to terminate the program. So this is how we are expecting the program to go. Now let us analyze the program, how we are going to do that. So yes, this is a program. We have to check all the 256 byte of data, that is from 6200 to 6300. So getting the number to check for the same number, store the count of the same number. So kitne jagah kitne bar wo aaya hai, that is what is to be counted. And compare the number with the specified number, that is EB. This is a simple logic, store count of the number in register D. And this is how it can be shown. So if the content of accumulator is EB, and if the content of the memory location is EB again, then what will happen? It's not going to change this content, but yeah, it is going to set the zero flag. And if it is set, then we have to increment the count in register D. Otherwise, we are going to check for the another number with the accumulator. So this is how the logic of the program goes. Like, so we need to check every time what is EB, where the EB is appearing. So sometimes you might have seen that in the word also, we need to search for some particular word, right? And we need to change all those words. So for that, we have to write a particular program. So the same program is like this. So we just need to check EB in this 256 byte, right? So this is the basic program of that. Now let us start with the program. So it's going to check like this. So we have not return the program, like, just give me a moment. So I will just put that. Yeah, it is actually B16. So I'll be putting it over here. store the result in register D. So let us like this. Yeah. So yes, so we need to do a program like this. So yeah. So again, this is a program, and this is how we are supposed to write. Some last day student was asking, sir, how I am going to write this program. So you need to write like this only. So write the program, the question that is there, that is B16, some data is stored like this, and then start this break. Prepare this table and start writing this. So memory location, label, mnemonics, opcode, and remark. And accordingly, you can start like this. So for this program, let us start with the first instruction. What should be the first instruction? Any guesses? Now you have done so many programs. So what instruction should I write for this? The first instruction that we usually write. Somebody can unmute themselves and say something on this. Shobhit, Surbhi, would you like to give? Hello, am I audible? Hello.
Sir, LXIH?
Yeah, LXIH, yes, exactly. So that is what we usually write. So now we need to put it like LXIH 6200, right? So we'll be writing here 6200. Just hold for a second. Yeah, we'll do that. So, yes. So we'll be putting, 6200. And what is the opcode for it? Yes, it is 210062 again. So we need to change that also. So remember this. This is will change. Then what we are going to do? Load the address of the memory location. So we have loaded it. Like, and again we need to change this also, because the memory location should not be start from here. We can start it from 600. Right. So let me do that for you. So it should be like 600. It should be like, 6-2. So these are some of the changes we need to do every time, because we are supposed to write it on in the so the data is stored from 6200. So we are not able to write it from the program from 6200. So we have to change that. So we are changing it to 600. So every time it's going to change, I guess. You might be seeing this. So this is what I need to do for each and every program that I need to write. So this is there. So I guess this is complete now. Yeah. So we have started writing the program from a memory location 600. Our data is stored in 6200. So we have 210062. This is the address of the data which is stored from 6200. The next instruction should be the count. So what should be the instruction? Somebody might tell again. So I was expecting from answers from your side now. So what should be the next instruction? I needed to store the counter over there. So that 256 times it should repeat. So what should be that? Hello.
MVI.
Yeah, good. Go ahead. MVI.
B.
B, right. MVI B SF, right? Because 256 byte hai, 256 numbers hai, so hum log SF le le. So SF stands for 256. SF in hexadecimal, 256 in decimal, right? So I'm writing there MVI B SF, right? So this is the opcode of that 0632. So it is again needs to be changed. It should be SF. Yes. So there are many changes. So we'll keep on changing that. So yes, it is MVIBFF and it should be 06FF. This is for the counter, that is the total numbers to be set. The second one should be, what should be it? So this is for to load the number of counts. So iske liye kya, kaun sa instruction again? Somebody? Yeah, good. Can anybody reply on that? Jagdish Shaw is there. Surbhi Dange. Beta, aap log abhi reply karte jao. Hello. Shobhit. Kya likhe instruction?
Sir, MOVC. Counter mein agar dal.
वो सी कैसे लिखेंगे बेटा, फिर से वो उसको डी में रखना है इस इनकेस मुझे काउंटर, तो मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा, डी को जीरो जीरो करना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि जब भी नंबर आएगा हम उसको इंक्रीमेंट करते
जाएंगे। एम वी आई डी जीरो जीरो।
हाँ वेरी गुड, एम वी आई डी जीरो जीरो, वेरी नाइस, आई लाइक इट, है ना। सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू इंक्रीज द काउंट इन डी, सो वी विल ऑलवेज, जब भी हमको ईपी मिलेगा विल इंक्रीमेंट द काउंट, राइट, वेरी नाइस। सो कीप मी से कीप गिविंग मी फीडबैक 16 टू स्टोर द काउंट, यस, सो वी हैव मेड दिस। नाउ अनदर इंस्ट्रक्शन इज सेम इज दैट, सेम इज लाइक दैट, बट दिस इज फॉर द एक्युमुलेटर। सो व्हाट नंबर शुड आई स्टोर इन द एक्युमुलेटर नाउ, यस, द थर्ड इंस्ट्रक्शन सेम, व्हाट शुड बी इट, यस, वेरी नाइस। तो जितने लोग समझ रहे हैं उनके लिए बहुत अच्छा है, काइंडली गिव मी द आंसर। सो व्हाट शुड आई राइट इन दिस, एम वी आई, या एम वी आई ए ई बी, है ना। अभी हमको क्या चेक करना है, ईबी कितने बार आया है ये चेक करना है, तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, ईबी चेक करेंगे, सो दैट इज एम वी आई ए ई बी थ्री ई ई बी, राइट। फिर इसके बाद दिस इज द स्पेसिफाइड नंबर दैट इज टू बी चेक्ड विद, तो ये आ गया, अब हमारा डेटा पूरा कंप्लीट हो गया, जो पहला डिफाइन करने वाला पोर्शन जो है वो हो गया है डेटा लेकर, अब हम लोग स्टार्ट करेंगे मेन प्रोग्राम। सो नाउ दिस इज कंपेयर एम, सो टीवी इज बीइंग कंपेयर्ड विद द फर्स्ट डेटा दैट इज इन द मेमोरी लोकेशन 6200, सो दैट इज द opcode of that, so we are checking for that similar number, then again 6007, so jump if zero, agar abhi zero hai, yani kya hua, carry flag zero ho gaya, right, so carry flag agar zero hai, to humko jump karna hai, humko increment nahi karna hai, agar carry flag zero nahi hai, matlab kya hua, if it is not zero, it implies that it is set, right, and if it is set, then it should increment the register D, right? So ये वाला instruction आएगा INRD. अभी हमने ये लिखा नहीं है क्योंकि वो instruction कहाँ jump करने वाला है वो हमको पता नहीं है, तो मैं शायद ये भी हमको change करना पड़ेगा, right? देखते हैं. So yes, if the similar number, so increment the count, right? Then yeah, so it just jump if zero should jump over here, zero B पे. तो हमको ये लिखना पड़ेगा 0B60, राइट, तो ये मैं यहाँ पर अभी आपके सामने ही चेंज कर देता हूँ, सी ए 0B और ये आएगा 60, राइट, और ये भी होगा 60, 06 पर ही जंप कर रहा है क्या, कहाँ जंप करेगा ये, 09 पे, या 09, यस, कंपेयर वहां जा रहा है, वेरी गुड। So yeah, so now we have done with this, yeah, complete, then compare M, then jump if zero to forward, and if it is equal then it will increment the number of count, and if it is not then it will jump to this number that is CA0B260, so this will jump over here, the next instruction will next number that is increment X, then decrement the count that is DCRP, then that is the opcode 05, decrement the count, and if it is not zero then jump to back. Now where it is, where it needs to jump is here, back C20960, back aayega shayad last mein aayega, so if not repeat for the next number, and if it is complete then last instruction should be kya rahega, last instruction, anybody can tell,
halt,
halt, yeah, ये तो अभी याद हो गया होगा आप लोगों को, ओहो, move A to D लिखा है, पर ठीक है, ये हमको नहीं करना है, सीधा सीधा halt करेंगे हम लोग इसका, तो ये हम लोग नहीं use करेंगे, we'll use the last instruction that is halt, yes, stop processing, so 6100 पर, sorry, 6010 पर halt हो जाएगा, so this is the program to find how many times EB appears, I guess you have understood this program. अगर अभी आपके सामने ये रखा हुआ है, इफ यू हैव एनी क्यूरीज ऑन दैट लेट मी नो, आप अभी क्वेश्चंस पूछ सकते हो, है क्या कोई क्यूरीज, ये लास्ट वाला इंस्ट्रक्शन नहीं है इसमें, बाकी आई गेस एवरीथिंग इज फाइन ओवर देयर. तो ये बैक वाला भी शायद इधर आएगा. या बैक देखो बराबर जगह पर आएगा, तो यहाँ पर भी वो जंप करेगा. तो जंप इफ नॉट जीरो विल जंप ओवर हियर एट दिस लोकेशन दैट इज 6009 कंपेयर एम राइट. तो यहाँ जंप करके वो वापस आएगा. सो इट विल फॉर्म इन अ लूप. सो इफ यू हैव एनी इश्यूज इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम्स लेट मी आस्क और विल ट्राई टू रन दिस प्रोग्राम. क्या करें, रन करने के लिए कोशिश करेगा प्रोग्राम की कैसा करें. तो दिस इज द एंड.
यस सर, रन करके देखते हैं.
रन करके देखते हैं. वेरी नाइस. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच. लेट अस सी हाउ इट गोज. आई विल स्टॉप शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन बट आई विल आस्क यू टू काइंडली 6010 मेमोरी लोकेशन लिखनी है क्या. ओके मयूरी बेटा 6010 मेमोरी लोकेशन तो लिखना पड़ेगा आपको. उसमें एक्चुअली हमारा लास्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन आने वाला है. सो जस्ट होल्ड फॉर अ सेकेंड. आई गेस मैं ये 1 2 3 को रिमूव कर देता हूँ और इसको भी रिमूव कर देता हूँ. तो अब मुझे आप लोग थोड़ा सा बताना क्योंकि मैं अभी आपको प्रोग्राम करके देखते हैं हम लोग. तो आई गेस ये इतना ही प्रोग्राम है हमारा. ओहो यस. तो जस्ट होल्ड फॉर अ सेकेंड. मैं इसको अभी आपको करके दिखाता हूँ. इसको मुझे थोड़ा मिनिमाइज करना पड़ेगा सो दैट आई कुड गेट द प्रोग्राम. यस सो या सो इट इज विजिबल टू यू ऑल. एम आई विजिबल? Yeah, now let us start with our programming part. So I guess the mobile is visible to you. So that I will, where should I put? Yeah. So yes, it is visible to you. Let me start our programming section. So yeah, I am using this. And yes. So we will start program. Yeah, this is okay. So it is visible. Is it visible? So I will start with this. Reset, substitute memory. We are writing it from 6000. Next. Right? Is it visible? Just keep me updated so that we can.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. So the first instruction, that is 21. We are loading it. Next, 00. Next, 60. 62, I guess. So 62. Yes. Next. Right? Then we are having 06. Then we are having next FF. Yes. FF. And in next memory location, that is 6005, we are having MVID 00. The opcode is 16. And 00. This is for the count. Next is 6007. That is MVIAEB. So we are using 3E. Next EB. Okay, where is B? Yeah. So EB is there. Then next, compare M. That is BE. So this is B, this is E. Next, 600A. I guess it is okay. We have to change this, no? 009. This should be 600A. A B C. Right? A B C. And this might come to D. So just hold for a second. I'm just replacing some more. B, then this should be E. Yeah. E. And this is F. Now it will start from 10. So 10, 11, 12, and this might appear at 13. Yeah. Now it is okay. So 600A will have jump is 0. So that is CA. So CA, next, the memory location will be 0E. So this will also change. Yes, it will come at shift E. 0E, 600B, na? 0E. Okay. Then next, 60. Next, in D, increment D, that is 14. Next, INXH, 23, that is E. Perfect. Then in F, DCRB, so 05. Yes. Then in 6010, jump if not 0, that we are going to write C2, next 09 0 1 2 3 4 yes 9 then 6 0 oh wait previous C2 09 6 0. Yes, and lastly 76. So 76 6013 pe 76 aa raha hai. So I will just show it to you again. Let me share my screen. Yeah, hold it for a second. Where is that? Yes. So my screen is visible to you. Hello? Ye presentation dikh raha hai?
Yes, sir.
तो ये प्रेजेंटेशन में देखिए, ये वाला अभी चेंजेस किए है, मेमोरी लोकेशन के चेंज हुए है. तो ये 00 से स्टार्ट किया, 01 02 03 04 05 06 07 08 09, 0A पे आ रहा है, फिर 0B 0C छोड़ा, 0D 0E 0E पे जंप इफ नॉट 0 आ रहा है, तो दैट इज 0E रिटर्न. यहाँ 23, देन 0F DCRB, then 10 per jump if not 0. So we are jumping to back compare MP aega, so that is 09 60, 13 pe halt aa raha, right? So just go through that. So this is now we have checked. So again I will check for you. Next reset, substitute memory 6000. Next, now go through that. 21 00 62, right? 62, I guess it is visible. Then 06F FF, then 16 00, then 3E EV BE, CA 0E 60 14 23 05, C2 09 60 76. Yes, is it okay now? Okay, so shall we go? Acha, one more thing. Next, reset. We need to go to 6200 also. Reset 6200. Reset substitute memory 6200. So we have to go over here also. So I guess yahan par EB hoga bahut baar, par hum log do char EB dal dete apne se, aise hi, hai na? तो हमको पता रहेगा कि हमने यहाँ पर ईबी लिखा है. अगर ईबी नहीं है वहां तो वो चेक करके क्या बताएगा. तो चार पांच ईबी डाल दो यहाँ और नेक्स्ट करके छोड़ दो. तो नेक्स्ट रिसेट गो, नाउ आई एम एग्जीक्यूटिंग इट 6000 एग्जीक्यूट. तो यस, इट इज एग्जीक्यूटेड बट इट इज शोइंग सम एरर. लेट मी चेक. सो रिसेट go 6000 execute. It is again showing error. Let us check. Substitute memory 600. Acha, substitute memory 6000. Next, dekhiye kahin to bhi program gadbad hua hai. We can check. So 21 00 6206 ff 16 00, I think 3EEB बराबर है BE, कोई इंस्ट्रक्शन इधर उधर हुआ है क्या, चेक करना, जंप इफ 0 CA 0E 60 14 and 2 3 इंक्रीमेंट H 0 5 डिक्रीमेंट B C 2 0 9 60 लास्ट 76। ये प्रोग्राम बराबर है क्या, इज इट ओके, बट इट्स नॉट वर्किंग, सो नेक्स्ट रीसेट गो 6000 एग्जीक्यूट, इट इज शोइंग एरर, आई गेस इट वोंट वर्क। अच्छा it is a long array, it is showing that it is a long array, so I guess it won't work in this, but yes it might work on the microprocessor kit, so microprocessor kit par hum log karke dekhenge, you just go through that. Acha, we can do one more thing, we might check it for reset substitute memory 6000 next, to hum log kya karte hain, ye jo humne dala hai ff dala hai, इसको हम लोग 0A कर लेते हैं, 10 नंबर के लिए चेक करते, ठीक है, अगर 10 नंबर चेक हो रहे हैं तो बाकी हो जाएगा, तो रीसेट गो 6000 एग्जीक्यूट, या नाउ इट इज एग्जीक्यूट, नाउ रीसेट विल चेक एग्जाम रजिस्टर डी, या इट इज शोइंग 7, सो इट वर्क्स फॉर अ स्मॉलर स्मॉल लेंथ प्रोग्राम, इफ हायर लेंथ प्रोग्राम कैन नॉट वर्क, राइट, सो जस्ट गो थ्रू दैट, we have just changed this ff, right, we have taken just 10 numbers, and if it works for 10 numbers then it will work for the other numbers too, so thank you, I guess you have understood, if you have any questions kindly let me know, yeah, thank you Shobhit, we have only 1 minute to go sir, CA0B60 kya hua Mayuri iska, ye kya puch rahe ho iska, अभी मीटिंग एंड हो जाएगी सर, बोलो, यू कैन अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, हेलो, चेंज हो सकता है क्या 600A में, नो बेटा, वो प्रोग्राम में आप चेक कर लो तो उसके हिसाब से वो बताएगा, नॉट लाइक दिस बट राइट नाउ आई कैन टेल यू दैट, ठीक है, द प्रोग्राम इज रनिंग, जस्ट हम लोग उसको एफएफ किए थे तो वो 10 करके थे, 0A कर रहे, तो 10 नंबर, if it is going to check 10 numbers then it is also going to check 256 number, wo program ka length pad raha hai aur hamare isme unhone wo diya nahi hai uske wajah se it is not working, micro processor pe wo kaam kare, right, so I guess thank you very much for the patience listening and I wish that ha beta we will do this, ha ff ki jagah 0a karna, yes exactly, so hamare मोबाइल पे काम करेगा आई गेस, राइट, नहीं तो और एंड अदरवाइज इट विल वर्क, वेरी गुड, सो आई गेस इट इज वर्किंग फॉर मोर देन हाफ एन आवर, जूम इज वर्किंग, सो टुडे ओनली आई हैव अपग्रेडेड इट, सो जस्ट होल्ड फॉर, या थैंक यू वेरी मच, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस पुट इट ऑन कमेंट बॉक्स एंड गो थ्रू माय यूट्यूब चैनल, आई विल बी अपलोडिंग दिस ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल टू, एंड I expect from your side that you will be doing good in programming in 8085 because we are working for the some more further advancement in programming, that is Python, C++, microcontrollers and more. So we need to learn some of the basics of these programming first and then only we can understand the other programs also. So thank you very much for joining and I wish that everything is fine at your end. Stay home, stay safe and take care. Good day. See you soon in the next class, hopefully tomorrow at 11. Bye. See you.